Hey guys, what's going on? And welcome back to the Old Smart RTG. And it is time for the record breaker. 7-7. Joe Willock played a month. Phenomenal card here. I've got him released. 92 rated. 82. 82 in May. Thanks a lot, EA. I don't even think I'd have unlocked this card if it was a month, 2 months into the game cycle, let alone in basically June. Okay, the least you could have done was release him as a record breaker, but that's fine. Let's go and check out what he's offering with his in-game stats. 74 finishing, 72 composure, and 67 defensive awareness. Okay, that's nice. I'm going to really want to use this card fighting for the Team of the Season Foot Champ rewards. Good pace, though. I like my pace. Good agility, I guess. And nice stamina. What's his traits? Oh, he doesn't have any. High tie work rate, 6'1". We got to get him in. He's a good lad. He basically kept us up in the Prem. The least I can do is unlock the card. Yeah. How are you guys doing? Hopefully you're feeling great. Are your weekly runs going well? Well, you know how he bought Jadon Sancho. 2.5 million coins. Has he lived up to expectation? Maybe. Maybe not. Well, I've got Foot Champs highlights to commentate over in 2 seconds. But Joe Willock, come on in. Don't you worry. I'll treat you well, Joe Willock. EA, you need to switch it up. For next year, it should be based on IRL, yes, but also in line with Foot Champ boosts, Team of the Season cards, whatever you want to release. Okay? So if we've got Team of the Season, this could be a Team of the Season version of a player of the month. You get me? I think so. But does he walk out at least? He's very cheap. What was it? 80 rated, which is absolutely nothing. But what you get back is a beautiful card. I've always liked the player of the month versions. Just the visually looks good. But yeah, Joe Willock, nicely done. Well, let's jump into the weekend league. It is Foot Champs time. 3-0 we resume, and we're coming up against Lingardinho. He's got himself Lautaro Martinez in there. Hold on, I can't see. It's too small. Let me zoom in real quick. Anyway, Sabitzer on the score sheet. Trust me, right? You think I'm just making this up. Sabitzer is a very solid centre mid. And if you're needing someone to overlap and get the goals, he's your man. We've got Jadon Sancho already. Wow, that was quick. Already on the score sheet, Jadon Sancho. And you're going to be seeing a continuous trend with him scoring goals over and over. But what I have noticed, though, is my attack really hasn't been as good as it was last week. But it probably is just me. You know how I feel sometimes on the game? A bit iffy. And I want to put it down to the lack of skill and quality for myself. Not Jadon Sancho. But he has been scoring like a fair amount of goals. This guy's team was absolutely rubbish. For a squad in May, June, like, you're not really going to be competing at a decent level. So although I'd like to celebrate the result, you've got to consider what you're coming up against as well. He gave a good fight, though. It took me quite a while to get going, and it's the 48th minute, and we're only winning 1-0. But Jadon Sancho, what a strike. You talk about a rocket, a Bobby Dazzler. That is a nasty finish. Oh, dear. That overpowered through ball. You think you've seen it worse than that? Oh, no, you haven't. You wait. I have a clip to show you. It's like a bleeding sat-nav. Honestly, he's punched in the destination and it has ignored every single one of my defenders. I was in shock, right? But the ball was going to R9. Do you know what I feel like increases the passing accuracy? I've always thought this, is that if you have someone with average like playmaking, but you've got a really good striker in your starting 11, like an R9, a CR7 team of the season with mad positioning and stuff, I swear it helps the ball get to them. Or have I just made that up? I don't know. I probably have just made it up. But is that Jadon Sancho again? Hold on a minute. Where are your ankles gone? Who's that? Who's just been completely ripped in two? That's what Sancho's about. What I have been surprised, though, is his left foot finishing is really consistent as well. But so it should be. He has 99 finishing stat. If he's missing any silly chances, then I'm going to be a little bit annoyed. But this is the game you want to pay attention to, right? TM Busquets, all right? Ready? 3, 2, 1. Oh my goodness me. Like, how has that possibly gone through? I've not only got one, two, but three. Okay, I got two. One of them wasn't really in the play. Two defenders ready to block the through ball. Nope. Not in EA's eyes. That has to connect with the striker. Fair enough. We're 2-0 down. But do we ever give up? That is the question. No, we don't. We keep pushing, and it's a beautiful goal from Sancho once again. I like it when he gets into that area, you know, and the ball's just drifting across his body, like left foot, right foot, he's going to get it. And he has finished on a phenomenal goal scoring record, really. His finesse shots are beautiful. And even on the edge where I was a little bit unsure as to what he would offer, because obviously we've been using Harvey Barnes and his finishing stat, or at least the long shot one, is 95 plus. And I've been scoring a lot of goals just like that. Sabitzer though, what a finish. Just like that with Harvey Barnes. And Sancho has not disappointed. For 2.5 million, you do get quite a lot for the money. And I still stick by that. By the way, Coutinho is like the fastest player on the game. Breaking away from the midfield. No wonder I've been using him in that position. Like subconsciously, I just maybe haven't really picked up on what he's doing. Or maybe what I have. I don't know. But he's just insane. He's so fast to break away. And that was Valverde team of the season. Like some people said, are you interested in the Valverde? Do you want to bring him in? Well, I was. Until I realized that a lot of people say he's a bit of a fraud. And he doesn't feel as good on the ball. Maybe not as fast. I'm not so sure. This guy loved a bit of keeper movement. And that was his downfall. This was the guy that was beating us 2-0 a minute ago. And he's lost, what, 6-3? Don't move your keeper. Schmeichel played a month, though. Played a month. Primeichel Moments is a joke. He really is one of the best keepers that I face. Although he conceded 6 goals in that game, you can't really expect your goalkeeper to bail you out after your opponent's had 20-odd chances. But if you're someone that only gives up like 1 or 2, Schmeichel's a very good keeper and he will win you the game. He will clutch up when you're desperate to make a save. But Coutinho again, Lazaro, still loving Lazaro. I can't stop using him. It's just the 5-star skills. But Sancho, I like that. I like that movement right there. By the way, GG. Thank you, Sabitzer, once again. But it's the tight turns that you get, that initial turn with Sancho, which is really nice, and it feels fluid. Even though he has the average body type, he can really twist and turn and get some yards on your opponent, so you can open up the space for a pass, or you set up your own skill, you take the shot. He's really, really good with it. Oh dear, we've conceded another goal. That was one of those where it was more of a 50-50, and Messi just got the advantage. He ran through. But do we ever quit? No, we don't. Roussillon, I told you, one of the best free unlocks in the right place at the right time. We have not missed 2 penalties already yet. We have, I don't want to show that. I don't want to embarrass myself, you know. Sancho to step up, 2.5 million. Come on, Sancho. We're going to get back into this one, no problem. He hasn't even hit the target. Okay, well, we've lost the penalty shootout. So now we're currently 8-1 in the weekend league, which is still pretty good. This guy had an amazing team. Rafael Varane, where are these guys getting the coins from? For real, I've seen some team of the season Rafael Varane's pop up a lot more often than some of the other cards, like the cheaper ones. So they're not messing about. And we haven't even hit the ultimate team of the season lineup yet. So God knows what's going to really happen to the player prices. But once again, Coutinho on the score sheet, feeling good. 2-0 in this game. Surely we can't choke. Well, maybe. Maybe we can, maybe we can't. But we do have... Sorry, what was that? Did he just pass it back to me? My game froze. I don't know. I don't even know how we've been able to regain possession. Oh, that was poor from me. Hold on a minute. Insigne has taken the ball off of Vieira. Oh, that was awful defending. Oh, dear. Oh, that was bad. So we made a mistake. We were taking too long on the ball with Vieira, and then we pull over our defender. Oh, that I don't want to watch that again. Well, no, you do. You want to watch it. If you want to get better, wow. How much space does Sabitzer want? And another goalkeeper mover? Like, why did he move him so early? I was even saying it to the stream, like, that was a little bit odd. Does he expect me to take a shot from, like, 50 yards? Hold on a minute. This was the game where Atal was performing some really odd chip animations. Since the patch, I've noticed it. Instead of getting like a really nice, like lofted chip that he would usually do, or maybe it was just that game, but he smacked one of them straight at Schmeichel's head, and then the other was that one. It still goes in, but it's a really bizarre animation, don't you think? But boys, we're 9-1. 9-1 in the weekend league. Jadon Sancho's goal scoring record looks absolutely phenomenal. You ready to see it? I think so. Let's go back to the club. And I'll show you some of these stats. Sorry, real quick, I forgot about Auer. He came out as an SBC, four star, 5'9". And remember his foot freeze card? He had a phenomenal finish. A heck of a finish on that card. And they've given him 97 attack positioning, mad stats all across the board. Do we do him? And I was thinking to myself, maybe hold off a little bit because they might release a team of the season Attel or a card that we really, really want to do. Whereas our, how long would we get use out of him? Like Patrick Vieira chemistry, okay, but I'm intending to sell Vieira anyway after the ultimate team of the season lineup. So do you want me to do him? He's an 87 squad and an 86, if I remember rightly. And the stamina is pretty high. Is he going to be better than Sabitzer? Probably on the ball. But physicality-wise, strength and aggression, it's not that high. So it puts me off a little bit. Because in the midfield, I do want someone, especially playing the role that Al would take up. It's not Coutinho just pushing on and doing his thing. It's the box-to-box guy. So he's got to track back and he's got to bully the opponents off the ball. And that's why I've been enjoying Sabitzer. Like, seriously, I didn't think that I'd get on with the card as much as I would. But 12 games, 7 goals, 6 assists, that is fantastic. That's a really good return, better than Mateus. Not lying. So high work rates, good physical play, nice defending, and he's okay on the ball. Really well and truly recommend this card. And he is 100... No, he's not even that. He's like under 100,000 coins. That's a steal if you've got a Bundesliga setup. But Jadon Sancho, what has this guy finished on in the first 11 games? Because I did accidentally go into a Division Rivals match. Are you ready? Is it better than Barnes? 11 games, 18 goals and 6 assists. Fantastic. Mental, really. So 18 goals and a lot of the strikes have been fantastic. On the edge of the box, finesse shots, first time strikes. He really does have a good finish. And on the ball, I've got no real issue. I think it was just the way I was playing with my players and just the lack of build up and the lack of creativity. But what he's going to offer is just phenomenal finishing. And that's what I get from the card. Really consistent in front of goal. The 90 composure, the reactions, the stamina, and a little bit of strength. He's really good. Really, really good. And I like him a lot. Very pricey though. 2.5 million. It's not cheap. But when you go and check out a Neymar right now that's been released at 11 million coins, that's mental. Is he still 11 million? It's crazy. I swear a few years ago, a Neymar team of the season would have been like 2 million coins, 2.5. I don't know what's happened to the market. I really don't. Next year, I want to have an account that is just completely stacked so I can try any card that I want. And to be able to like get my hands on these players, you're going to have to be spending thousands and thousands on the game. It's absolutely ridiculous. 9.4 million he is, but what a card. That does look beautiful. I'd love to get Neymar. Well, that's what I'm playing for. That's why we're all playing Foot Champs right now. The red picks and that possibility of packing the Neymar or Mbappe. Honestly, the Liga 1 team of the season, I really like the look of. If you're after my opinion on a few of the cards, Marquinhos, I think, is going to be really, really good. I can't wait to... I went to the wrong team of the season. Can't wait to test him out. You've got Ben Yedder that I don't doubt is going to be a phenomenal finisher. Di Maria, they could have increased his weak foot a little bit more, and then he would have been a phenomenal attacker. Depay, I worry for his body type, but with his stats alone, he just looks sick. And then obviously we've got Marquinhos here. I just think he's going to play so well in game. Really want to get my hands on him at some point. Well, I've got the coins. I will have the coins anyway. We've got this weekend Liga 1. Then we've got ultimate team of the season. And then after that, I'm selling everything. And we're going to go crazy and build a super, super fun team. Not like a fun team that's bad, like a fun team with OP players that are different. So I hope you enjoy that. But thank you very much for watching. We're 9-1 in the weekend league. We're feeling all right. Sancho's still killing it. Thank you very much for watching. Drop a like and I'll see you boys on the next one. Team out. Peace.